emerging from the same Bay Area thrash scene that spawned acts such as Metallica and Exodus, possessed were the trailblazers for what would become death metal, building the bridge between thrash and death. In a way, they were the venom of death metal in that they helped create the genre, but were never fully acknowledged for their contributions, especially after Death's Scream Bloody Gore came out in 87. Now, I'll have to admit, I am really not a fan of death metal at all, but every subgenre has its jewels, and when it comes to death metal, Possessed are it. The band was almost cut short, however, due to personal tragedy after releasing only two albums and an EP. But frontman Jeff Becerra would reform the band 20 years later with a new lineup. So let's get right into this, starting with Seven Churches. Out of all three of their albums, Possessed made the most impact with Seven Churches. Seven Churches is a raw, uncut album with the production quality of a bombing raid, complete with blazing guitar riffs straight from Satan's asshole. With songs titled Pentagram, Burning in Hell, and Fallen Angel, along with the satanic iconography, it was no surprise that Possessed found themselves on the shit list of many evangelical Christians during the height of the satanic panic of the 80s. Some Christians allegedly tried to take out frontman Jeff Becerra in the shooting, but missed all those shots.
Yeah, I got shot at by some Christians.
Was that related?
They missed that time. Oh, yeah.
Musically, Seven Churches is more aligned with thrash, but mixed with Jeff Becerra's growling death metal vocals. The best songs on here, Fallen Angel, and the last track, the one that coined the phrase, death metal. Now, Seven Churches Possessed were able to find their sweet spot between ultra fast and musically incoherent, which is what many death metal bands fail to do. Most of the time, they just downtune the guitars and you can't even tell what fucking note they're playing. Seven Churches evolved the thrash metal sound as well as laid the groundwork for a whole nother genre, and is essential whether you're into thrash metal, death metal, or just brutal aggression. After the backlash received from Seven Churches and the fact it was banned for being sold at almost every retail store, Possessed decided to tone it down a little on Beyond the Gates.
Before, on the first album we did, it was all, you know, more like a kind of black magic type of thing. This one here is more of a, you know, it's got different subjects. It's not all about one thing, like March to Die. It's basically about kind of a war kind of thing and stuff like that. That's what's, you know, really what we wanted to do. We wanted to make more, you know, songs instead of one subject.
And apparently they decided to save a few bucks and record the album in a truck stop bathroom too. And like Seven Churches, Beyond the Gates is more in tune with thrash than it is with death metal, and many of the themes are centered on the Book of Revelations rather than Satanism. I remember I was first caught off guard with the Depeche Mode synthesizer in the beginning, but as soon as the Heretic kicks in, you know you are in for thrash metal pummeling. Apart from being fast, Beyond the Gates is a little more technical and the leads are more complex, instead of just repetitive death metal riffs. Beyond the Gates was widely shit on by Possessed fans, and I for one don't understand why, because it does anything but suck. I guess people are just assholed that they didn't put out a try-hard snooze fest and actually put some effort and talent into it. Favorite song on the album? I would have to say Phantasm, with the Lemmy Kilmister sounding vocals. Beyond the Gates would be Possessed's last LP until Revelations of Oblivion 33 years later. But as time has passed, Beyond the Gates has gained more acceptance amongst fans, and rightfully so. it can be looked at as possibly the first technical death metal album. The Eyes of Horror EP is the last thing recorded by Pozette's original lineup. It was produced by the highly influential guitarist Joe Satriani. The Eyes of Horror is in tow with Beyond the Gates, sticking to the more technical death metal style, yet maintaining a fervent thrash metal pacing. It was clear with this EP that Pozette were heading toward a more polished sound. As far as the tracks on Eyes of Horror, my belief is the better out of the five. This more polished sound on the EP never did get a chance to metastasize to a full-length album, seeing as Pozette would break up mere months after its release.
Like, we didn't fight till like right towards the end, and it wasn't even fighting, it was just like, we need to get the fuck away from each other, you know, so.
Guitarist Larry Lalonde would go on to form Primus, but tragedy would strike vocalist Jeff Beccaro, who would become paralyzed during a shooting robbery in 1989.
And unfortunately, shortly after that, you know, I was shot.
Jeff Beccaro would be out of the limelight for almost two decades while he faced recovery and was permanently confined to a wheelchair. The band would not reform until 2007, with Jeff Beccaro being the only remaining member of the original lineup.
To put together this band now, like, a lot of people think I just picked like a super group, but that's not true. These are all like my homies from back in the day. They're all veterans. Everybody who's in Pozette now earned their way there, just as much if not more.
It wasn't until 2019 that Pozette would put out their long-awaited third album. At last, the comeback album of the ages, complete with fiery technical death riffs, powerful vocal growls, and fixed with the original inverted cross in the logo. Everything on Revelations of Oblivion rips and leaves a statement that Pozette are here to stay. Revelations of Oblivion is more of a proper follow-up to the first album than anything, with its brooding themes of Satanism. There are also trinkets of black metal, which adds to the sinister blend. If you need a reason to believe this is the top-tier album of 2019, just listen to the face-melt engraving with the beautifully evil outro, Temple of Samuel. And there you have it. Pozette BTFO's every other band in 2019, and it's not even a comparison. With Revelations of Oblivion, Pozette retakes the crown of death metal kings after 30 years of stagnation, and they have come back with a vengeance. Here's to Jeff Beccaro and his future endeavors with Pozette, and I will see you on the next Retro Doc.